Good morning, welcome to Planet Mojo. Today, I'm gonna be wrapping up this XPS thermal bridging solution so I can move ahead with the Insul-Hold. Yesterday, I got this entire area done, this entire wall, all the way down to the corner there, all the way around to here, is complete. Today, I need to do this chunk here and that chunk there, and as much of that one as I can. I have a couple other things that I have to do on these walls as well. I have to put a gas line coming through the wall right here. And what else? Oh, I have an electric fixture that's going to be going on the outside right above the door. That has to go in before I can insulate this pocket up here. And what else? Oh, great stuff. Big foam is going to be going in here today. It's going to be sunny out, so it should be plenty warm enough to do this later on. I left my spritz water out here last night, and it's frozen solid as a rock. I'm gonna leave it on here in the sun on this black, and hopefully it'll thaw out. But if I do go in the house, I'll have to put that in some warm water because I'm gonna be spritzing this entire pocket before I foam it. You've already seen most of the techniques on this wall right here. Almost everything on that wall is gonna be a duplicate. But I'll show you a few things that I didn't show you last time, but for the most part, I'm gonna speed right through this. I gotta get this done today. Show this again because I don't think I did a very good job with the camera yesterday. This is that window detail, and this is an inch and a half gap. I could have filled that with foam, but this window member is dead plumb, and these columns are a little bit cockeyed, so the gap wouldn't have been filled completely. It's a lot easier to use the fiberglass to get that odd shape and fill it completely. So we have foam in the back, and we have structural members, and then this fiberglass is gonna cover the whole thing. I'll go all the way to the top. And then this piece, which has been sitting here since yesterday, is gonna cover the window area. Then the regular wall insulation will come right to the top of the window and then start from the bottom of the window and go down to the sill. I have the heater on this foam so it dries a little better. You could see that the foam up at the top isn't drying as fast as the foam down lower. And this is what it looks like until the foam on the inside. There's foam on the inside that isn't quite cured yet. And as it expands, it'll bust a little hole in this shell here and make all these noodles like this. Pretty interesting stuff. Once the stuff is all the way cured, I'll just take a knife and cut this flush. Okay, that's gonna wrap it up for today. I have 100% of the thermal breaks in place. And if you haven't been watching, that is 1.5 inch XPS foam. Got a little bit of fiberglass doing the same thing. So now I need to put in my pokey stabby strips. Take you on a tour here. Got that all done, all through here. Got this foamed. That still needs to be trimmed. This whole area, whole corner is done. The diagonal, fiberglass up there, and we wind up right back to here, right where we started from. So tomorrow, my goal is to get 100% of the Insul-Hold installed, the pokey stabby strips. And it gets 4 strips in each bay. These open bays are easier. Well, I don't know, I haven't done the other ones yet, but it looks like it'll take a full strip along the side and then 3 little ones above and below the window on these two. And on all of these with diagonals, I think I'm gonna have to start and stop them. I don't think there's gonna be any problem though. I think it's gonna go pretty smooth. So if you wanna see that, make sure you subscribe and click on the update icon. If you have any questions or comments, make sure you put them in the comment section below. And if you share the video and or give it a like, it helps the channel out greatly. Thanks for watching and have a great day.